the way Nescafe has plastered me all over the city, no other brand has, and it feels really, really good. Unless you're a big actor, unless you're a star, your face is not normally plastered all over the city like that.
You are this cerebral, intellectually sound and thinking sort of girl that they are trying to portray.
I don't know. I don't think it has been. It's been incredibly amazing. I couldn't have asked for more. I was offered this job of a bartender in Goa. Hi, I'm Teena Singh and you're watching me on Bollywood Hungama.
Well, you've seen her splashing from all the hoardings, both in Mumbai as well as all across India, and also the newspaper ads. You just cannot just escape her face. That's the Nescafe girl we're talking about, and her name is Teena Singh, if you are very curious to find out. And we have this here on Bollywood Hungama. Pleasure having you, first of all, on Bollywood Hungama.
Thank you.
And how does it feel that your face has been splashed all across? And apart from the fact that many actors, many girls, they're seen in ads, but somehow your entire look is getting noticed. That element of intensity is getting noticed as well. How do you react to all the attention that is coming your way?
You know, I've been doing ads for the last 3 years. I've been in Bombay, and right. I've been the face of a lot of big brands already. But the way Nescafe has plastered me all over the city, no other brand has, and it feels really, really good, because you feel like your work has finally been, you are being validated finally. Because what happens normally in India is, unless you're a big actor, unless you're a star, your face is not normally plastered all over the city like that. Even if you do big campaigns, like I have been a part of, the campaign is not necessarily primarily about the actor or the model. It is mostly about the branding of the campaign.
Sure.
So I think Nescafe has done so much justice to me by just putting me all over the city.
Right. You say that you are this cerebral, intellectually sound and thinking sort of girl that they are trying to portray?
I don't know. I don't think they're doing
that. That's what you come across as. Someone who's thinking maybe, and you're having your cup of coffee maybe early in the morning.
Yeah, I don't think there's so much thought that has gone behind that. The brief to me was, you know, you've just woken up and this is, you know, there's this girl next door who's just enjoying her coffee. It's raining. And she's just sort of, you know, in that dreamy space and just enjoying her coffee, looking out of her window.
Okay, so that's how beautiful you look when you wake up every day?
I think the credit will always go to, all of us, we have such an amazing team, you know, our hair and makeup artists, our stylists, you know, I think a lot of us don't stop to thank them, because you see us on the camera, but there's a whole team that goes around, you know, makes all the effort to make us look the way we do.
All right, and now Teena has also been seen in movies. She was seen in Akira. In recent times, she was also seen in Fitur. There's buzz that she'll be seen as a full-fledged actress, heroine, in one of the films that is coming up. So if we come down to your movie journey so far, you've been seen with Sonakshi in Akira,
yes.
And Fitur as well. And now you're having this this project which has come up where you're playing the main lead. So how's been the journey as far as you're concerned? You've also been a bartender in Goa for an year.
Oh God, you found that out.
Yes, okay, and you basically belong to Punjab.
Yeah.
And it must have been a very interesting journey so far for a single girl coming all the way and having no backing from any of the big daddies in Bollywood.
It has been. It's been incredibly amazing. I couldn't have asked for more. My family is in Punjab. I was born there.
Which city in Punjab?
Ludhiana.
Ludhiana, okay.
Yeah, and then I was sent to boarding school when I was, I think, 8 years old.
So
I grew up in boarding school. I was in Ambala for a year. Then I was in Dalhousie for a few years. It's in the hills. It's beautiful. Then I was in Simla for a few years. Then I moved to Delhi to do college. And then I started working in Delhi. I was doing PR and events.
Okay.
And then one day just got bored of that and said, you know, I'm going to Goa for this yoga retreat. So I did yoga for 2 months. And I remember calling my boss back home in Delhi and saying, hey, you know, I don't think I'm coming back anytime soon.
Right.
So, you know, I don't really plan things. I just sort of went with the flow. And then I got this, I was offered this job of a bartender in Goa. And it sounded really interesting. For me, every opportunity is a way to learn. So I was like, why not, you know? I mean, it's an interesting job. So I can literally make, you know, every cocktail out there. I'm not a big drinker, but I can make every cocktail. And so I was there in Goa for a year, and then I decided to come to Bombay, but not to become an actor. I mean, I hadn't even remotely thought of this. So I came here, I was doing events here, and I started getting offers to do ads once after I moved here. And initially I was, you know, I would always say, you know, I'm not interested. I would be really awkward in front of the camera. I've never done this.
Right.
And then I, you know, I did one ad because, you know, this casting director called me and she kept insisting. So, you know, I said, okay, I'll do this one ad. And then that ad sort of, you know, got me noticed, got me another ad. Then my, I think my second ad was a big ad and it went viral. And then, you know, it sort of just, and then after I think the first three, four ads, I kind of got interested and I said, you know, this is interesting and this is a lot of, this is good money. Then I started going to auditions, meeting people, and then 6 months into doing ads, Fitur was offered to me. They called me and they said, you know, we've seen your ads, and because they needed like a look, you know, short hair, tattoo artist. So I was called to audition. It was a very simple audition. There was not much, no lines. So I went and tested, and then a couple of days later, I was told, you know, you're on. So from doing ads to suddenly being on a film set like Fitur. Fitur was mounted on a very, very big scale.
Absolutely.
So I was just like this like kid in a candy shop. I would just look around and be like, wow. And then I did a few more ads. I think it's the look that got me noticed first because, you know, I had boy cut. Like right now, my hair is much longer. I had like a crew cut. And so suddenly, like, nobody in Indian advertising had seen that look before.
Ji.
So, you know, that sort of went, you know, viral, and everyone sort of, you know, stood up and said, who's this girl with the short hair and brown skin? And then eventually, I got a call from, a year into advertising, I got a call from Fox Studios saying, we're auditioning for this film. Would you like to come in and audition? And I said, why not? And I went and tested for it. And I think I didn't hear from them for about 3 months. And then 3 months later, they were like, you know, the director wants to meet you and you're on. So, yeah.
Great, great. And Akira as well, you've done with Sonakshi.
With Sonakshi, yes.
All right. Now, so what is this film that you've been offered as a main lead?
Oh, God.
You need not tell us everything, but we understand that. But still.
This is a film that is being produced by Triarch Entertainment.
Okay.
The guys that just made Toilet Tick in Kolkata.
Right.
They did Rustam last year. So this is the one I'm currently working on, and I don't think I'm allowed to reveal any more.
Anything apart from that?
Yeah. Oh. But yeah, I'm doing the film, and it's a great script. I'm very excited. My first lead film.
Okay, and I think you're not supposed to tell us who the co-star is either.
No.
Okay, so I'm sure that it'll be good, and we hope that it is good as well. Okay, but. You know, when I was just researching for you, what I found interesting was, you know, many girls, they come to Bombay and they have all these dreams, and many of them, they don't happen to realize them. I think you're on the verge of being there in terms of getting the recognition that maybe you had been hoping for.
I hope I do.
Inshallah, we hope that as well. And it looks like that as well. So my question to you is that, how is the journey like? You know, because you're coming from a middle class background, that's what I'm assuming.
Ah, yeah.
And then you're not having any big daddies out here, and then we've had this entire nepotism debate that has gone on for quite some time as well. So for someone who's not having any backing per se from within the film industry, just making your own inroads into the industry is something which is not easy. I feel, from whatever experience I've had and the way I've observed people and various stars as well, that I think a lot depends upon that how dignified you remain and how you carry yourself with dignity and the fact that you don't come across as too desperate or anything of that sort, because that's when people take advantage of you. What is your perception on that? Because how do you strike a balance that it should not come across as that you're being snooty or arrogant, at the same time it should not be as if you can be taken advantage of?
You know, for me, it's just been one simple thing. From the day I decided that I want to give this a shot, which was 3 years back, I just believe in working hard. I believe in focus. For me, focus is bigger than talent or anything else. So the day I decided that I want to do this, I just started going to auditions every day. And that's all that I've done. When I started 3 years back, I was going to like 3 auditions, 4 auditions every single day. Irrespective of, you know, I had literally had no social life. You know, when my friends were out there partying or, you know, doing things that other kids my age do, I was just relentlessly going to auditions every day. And I think that's the only thing that works. You know, a lot of people will tell you having contacts here works or being at the right place at the right time. None of those cliche things work. Those are things people tell themselves. Those are excuses people make for whatever reason. But there is no substitute for focus and hard work. So I've just gone to auditions every day. Now I don't do as many, thankfully, because, you know, now people sort of know me. I get direct calls.
Absolutely.
But the last 3 years, until Akira happened, I was doing 3 auditions every single day. Could have been, and for me, it's not about small ad audition, hai ki film audition. For me, there's no small, big. For me, it's work is work. So when I started out, I was doing, you know, I was doing montage ads. I was doing ads where I was, you know, in that ad with 3 other people. And then from I worked my way up from that point to like doing solo ads, to doing films, to now.
You've done an ad with Shraddha, I believe.
I've done an ad with Shraddha, yeah, which was recently for Acme.
Right.
Let's go. Kuch bhool to nahi rahi ho? Kya? Ye dekho. Haan? Par main to kuch hi minute se bahar hoon.
But none of that happens to you. Like, nobody is going to call you one day and say, hey, you know, I want to offer you this Lakme ad with Shraddha. You have to earn your place in the industry. Nobody owes you anything. Nobody is going to knock at your door and be like, hey, you know, I'm not a Teena Kapoor. I'm not a Teena Bhatt. Nobody's going to knock at my door and be like, hey, you know, you have to earn your place. You have to work your way up.
Do you have any apprehensions about, you know, India is, in spite of the fact that we've been the victims of racism in the biggest possible manner. But we tend to have this entire fixation with the fair skin part of it, and many of the actors, actresses, they tend to promote fair skin products and all that stuff, which a lot of people have an objection with. Is that something that you have to deal with, and how do you deal with it?
Yeah, I mean, I deal with it every day. I've dealt with it from the day I started. But I think that makes me work even harder. When you tell me I can't do something, I make sure I do it. So when I started going to auditions, I was told by a lot of casting directors, yaar, ek to tum gori nahi ho, upar se tumhara ye boycott hai, you know, it's never going to work for you. And they would literally not even, they would refuse to test me. They would just be like, matlab, don't waste your time and our time. And, you know, that is what kept me going even more. So I was like, no, I'm going to make sure that the brown skin and the hair gets accepted in the... so yeah, I just kept going to auditions. And eventually, you know, like once one ad is out, and then, I mean, you know, it eyeballs into, you know, other things. So, but I've had that a lot. In the beginning, I was constantly told, you know, your skin color, your hair, there are disadvantages, they're not going to work for you. But to me, in my mind, these were the things that were going to be my USP.
Sure.
Because there is no other girl that has this hair. There is no other girl who is so comfortable in her skin. I was told by casting directors to wear foundation and come to auditions. They're like, "Tumhe kaam chahiye na, foundation laga kar aao." And I was like, "No, I refuse. Even till late, I've never worn foundation to auditions." So, you know, I stuck to my ground. I said, you know, this is it, take it or leave it. And, you know, I think it's kind of worked.
No, it is working. I think that's something which is extremely important, because, you know, that's what we gather from whatever experience we've had in terms of meeting people, and that it's very important to put a fine line and be dignified at the same time, and still be, people should know that there is no arrogance or anything of that. So, because, you know, it is that judgmental factor is so strong. Either you are this or you are that. So, which is like, which can be quite tricky as well. Okay, now, could you tell us what all ads have you done? If you can get an idea. Like,
sure.
Nescafe has been there, Vicks is there, Lakme.
I've done ads for, I'll tell you, I'll start from my first ad.
Jee,
I started with Vicks, then I did a campaign for Samsung refrigerator, then I did Tata Safari, then I've done Tata Docomo, Asian Paints I did with Deepika.
Okay.
Then I've done L18 with Anushka. Then I've done pepper fry. I've done basically most of the brands that are in the Indian segment right now. Panasonic. I just did Lakme with Shraddha. I've done Ajio. I've done print campaigns for Kotak Mahindra, which was again which was plastered all over Bombay last year. But my face wasn't as prominently, you know, on the poster. Like you could tell it's me, but it wasn't as obvious as the Nescafe.
Great, great. Yeah. Okay, and I feel that you must have been told in terms of advantages that your voice is an advantage.
Oh God, yeah, I have.
You have like a nice voice that.
I have been told. Mm-hmm. I've also been told it's really strange. Yeah. Someone asked me, "You should dub for Priyanka Chopra," and I was like, okay. "I will dub for myself. You know, she's great. She's incredible. But you know, I don't want to dub for someone else."
Absolutely, that's.
I mean,
that's,
it's a compliment. I think she's got an incredible voice.
Right.
And so this person was trying to give me a compliment. He said, "You've got such a nice voice. You should dub for Priyanka."
No, I think that's an absolutely correct approach, because you should be yourself rather than me being someone else. Then what's the point? Teena, after this intense and intense round of questionnairing that we've had, now we'll have a bit of a fun segment, which is the rapid fire. So are you ready for your first rapid fire, Teena ji?
Oh God, these are really okay.
Don't worry. These are not like dicey. Yeah. They're fun.
Yeah, I just don't want to get into trouble.
No. Don't worry. We won't get you into trouble. Okay. We won't get you into trouble. All right, so rapid fire with Teena Singh. What is more satisfying, ads, films, or TV shows?
You know, I love being on any kind of set. I just love being on set. So, could be anything, film, ad, music video, anything. I just want to be on a film set every day of my life, on a set.
You've done music videos?
I've just done one, which is, I think it should release next week.
Okay, the hottest model according to you in ad world, apart from you, of course.
Hottest model.
Would you be vain enough to say that I am the hottest one around?
No, not at all.
Okay.
Not at all.
All right, so then hottest model according to you?
There is this girl called Nicole. Mm? There's this girl called Nicole. Yeah, I think she's stunning. She's really hot.
Okay, your definition of Netflix and chill?
Yeah, literally Netflix and chill. Just like eat lots of like popcorn or great food and just watch, binge watch.
Okay, what are your favorite band or artists? Who are your favorite bands and artists?
In India?
Mm-hmm.
I really like Indian Ocean.
Yeah,
really, really like their sound.
You're from Delhi, so obviously you must
I'm from Punjab.
But you've lived in Delhi,
I've lived in Delhi, yes.
Yeah, so you cannot escape Indian Ocean if you're living in Delhi.
Yeah, actually they've taken over, they're all over the
country. That's true.
Yeah.
But they're basically from Indian, from Delhi. Yeah. They live in Rahul Ram and... Sushmit strangely has left now. Okay, Fatal Attraction or True Love?
True love.
Okay. What's your zodiac sign?
Aries.
Arian. Okay. Yeah. What do you do on your day off?
I just want to not do anything on my day off. I just want to be at home, eat lots of food, and just not do anything. Just laze around and wear like my most comfortable pajamas and just chill.
Okay. Your ideal date?
Close to some water body, like maybe the sea or the beach, and again lots of food and great music.
But with a boy,
with a boy,
obviously,
of course.
Yeah, because you've described everything and not
that is understood. No, I mean with a boy.
The boy doesn't matter.
With a boy, of course.
No, but boy, what sort of boy?
What sort of boy?
The ideal date will also involve the boy.
Oh, I thought
as well.
You wanted like a setting.
Right.
Ideal date. You know, someone that's funny, someone that makes me laugh, someone who's not, I see a lot of guys today who take a woman out on a date and they're quite self-obsessed.
Someone with themselves?
Yeah, especially in our industry, it's all about like mirror, mai kaisa lag raha hun. So someone, if you're taking someone out on a date,
you should make that person feel special.
Yeah, someone who, you know, it should be about me, should make me feel special.
Absolutely.
And someone that can make me laugh. Is witty.
Okay.
Yeah.
Someone that who can make you laugh. Okay. All right. A recent film that you saw that you loved?
Lipstick Under My Vodka.
Okay. What's the most evil thing that you have ever done?
What is the most evil thing? I've done lots of evil things. I was in boarding school, so ragging my juniors. I was evil.
Okay, describe Teena Singh in just 3 words.
Spirited, resilient, strong.
How would you react to the following? How would you react to the following situation or any idea whatsoever? Mm-hmm. Okay, so what's your reaction to the following? Casting couch.
It's not happened to me. I don't know.
Okay, nepotism.
It exists, but you know, I mean, if you look at the best actresses in India today, Deepika, Anushka, Priyanka, they're all outsiders.
Right.
So if you've got what it takes, you'll be where you have to be.
Sure. Yeah. Okay, gender discrimination. Do you think that, does it exist?
In Bollywood? Or
anyway,
generally?
Anyway, of course. Have you experienced? Okay.
Of course, all the time. You walk down, not here especially, but Punjab where I come from, you cannot walk down the street without people, you know, passing comments or just like scanning you, like x-ray scanning you. It's everywhere.
Mm. Okay. Slut shaming.
Yeah, it's terrible. It shouldn't be done. I think people who do these things, it's all, I think it's a product of insecurity. If you're insecure, then you will, you know, make other people seem bad or lesser.
Okay, sexism.
Exists.
Okay, trolls. Have you experienced trolls
so
far?
Yeah. I really enjoy them. I think they're super entertaining. Again, it's a way of attention seeking.
Mm.
And they're basically, a lot of them are jobless people who are just seeking attention. And they're very entertaining. I love them.
That's good.
Yeah.
That's a good way of just addressing that.
Yeah.
Okay, double standards of society.
Yeah, there are. India especially. I mean, if you have a girl showing her midriff wearing jeans and a crop top, it's a big issue. But the same woman, you know, there could be a woman wearing a sari with a bigger midriff showing, and you know, that's extremely sanskari. You know, India, we're
okay. Like that's this. we can go on and on and on talking about that. Okay, so Teena Singh, it was wonderful.
Into a lot of trouble,
no. Don't worry about it. You know, the one thing is that I think you're doing everything right. Apart from that, it's important to speak your mind. Not too much, but
too much,
I think you're fine. You're just absolutely fine. So it's also important to be entertaining, you know, because you should come across as interesting.
Yeah,
because if you're playing it too safe, then it also becomes...
Yeah.
No, don't worry. If there's anything that you feel that it's not appropriate, you let us know. We won't carry that.
You chop it.
Yeah.
Great.
So, but I don't think that that there's anything that you should be worried about. All right, so it was wonderful having you, Teena, and best wishes for all that you're going to be doing in the near future. And congratulations for the tremendous, I think, response that you've been getting for Nescafe. It is something that is hard to miss. Thank you, everyone. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
That's all we have from Bollywood Hungama. Keep on watching.